Sheep or goat? Matthew chapter 25 verses 31 to 46. Here Jesus explicitly tells us who is going to heaven and who is going to hell. He divides the humanity into two teams, that is sheep and goat. Sheep, he declared, blessed, and he invites them to enter into his kingdom prepared by his Father since the foundation of the world. Goat team, he declared, accursed and are relegated to eternal punishment. Sheep team enjoys eternal happiness. Goat team suffers eternal punishments. Dear friends, let us ask ourselves, which team do we prefer to be on? Here, Jesus makes this choice more easy and comfortable one. A good teacher, while explaining the lessons to the students, he also explained the question which are asked during their examinations. The teacher prepares the students well, even the question may come in a tough way. Here, Jesus, our Lord and Master, releasing the question and making us easy to pass the examination. Give food to the hungry Jesus, water to thirsty Jesus, clothes to naked Jesus, visit the sick and suffering Jesus. உலகம் பிறந்தது எனக்காக, ஓடும் நதிகளும் எனக்காக, மலர்கள் மலர்வது எனக்காக, அன்னை மடியை விரித்தாள் எனக்காக என்று கவிஞர் கண்ணதாசன் பாடிய பாடல் வரி சொல்வதென்னவென்றால், நாம் எல்லோருமே பயனாளிகள், நமக்காகவே இறைவன் இவற்றை படைத்துள்ளார். So, let us share with our brothers and sisters who are in need. When we care our brothers and sisters, we are caring Jesus himself. Every time we neglect, reject, pass rash judgment, using abusive words, sarcastic remark, spoil others' name, backbiting, exploiting, we are doing all to Jesus. Sin of omission is very dangerous. Individually or corporately, we are called to help those in need. 1 Samuel chapter 25 verses 29 says this: we are bound in the bundle of the living under the care of the Lord your God, and we cannot ignore the plights of human beings suffering hunger, thirst, nakedness, homeless, sickness, or imprisonment. Book of Hebrews chapter 13 verses 1 to 3 says, we work hard in order to meet our own needs and the needs of those dependent on us. But we also work in order to have something to give to those in need. Jesus does not say exactly how the sheep served people in need. It may have been through gifts or charitable works, but perhaps some of it was through the ordinary work of growing and preparing food and drinks, helping the new co-workers come up to speed on the job, finding job to the jobless, helping the person one who is standing on the crossroad of his life. All the legitimate works which we do to others, we are doing to Jesus. Let us live justly and meet Jesus in our brothers and sisters. This will help us to join the team of sheep. Let us live like another Jesus. Have a grace-filled day, friends.